Hello, I am Pradnya from Science Activity Center, Aisar, Pune.
Hello, I am Neha, wishing you a very, very happy National Science Day.
On this occasion, I introduce you a person who has made lots of interesting toys by trash material, K.V. Poddar sir.
K.V. Poddar sir is a mechanical engineer by profession and worked in Techlo for 30 years. After his retirement, he pursued his passion to make the toys, or you can say science toys or crafts. He has designed many toys from trash material, which are documented in special category by his name on website arvindguptatoys.com. He participated in various science exhibitions for many years. Presently, he is associated in various activity with Aisar Pune. Let's look at some toys designed by sir. Here is our first one, a grinding model, which is used to grind our grains or species. In many years ago, these type of chakki are used to grind grains at home by ladies with lovely song. So, it is very cultural toy. Also, you can start thinking science behind that, basically towards the machine. There is a wheel and axle. Here is our next one, that is a moving footwear. Just look at the simplicity and creativity in this toy. How crank is used to move footwear to and fro. Interesting, no? Now, here is box, and this cut in such a way that it shows the rigidity. Just press and leave it immediately. Can you guess science behind it? Can you relate this toy with conversion of energies? Think on that. Move on to the next toy. In this toy, there is a fan which is made by some thick plastic sheet and a spoke it attached with a ring magnet. Also, there is a star shape which is made up of the spoke. Now, just blow the fan and observe the movement of a star shape. It's so interesting. What do you think? Why this is happening? You can also make different shape and observe it. Now, here is the next one, fun with 9 cubes. These 9 similar cubes are connected in such a way that if you can twist a diagonal cube, you can find the movement of all cubes, like they are dancing. It's fun, no? Now, there is a next one. Oh, it's a wire lizard. Just observe the movement of legs. It's so cool and amazing. For this, you have to move just a crank and all 4 legs starts moving. Here is the next one, rope jumping man. just move that crank and the man will jump. It's such an amazing toy. Now here is the next one. Can you observe the material? There is a plastic box. There is a pencil, a fan made of plastic material, and the ring magnet. Can you guess where is the pole of ring magnets? Ring magnets having their pole on the sides. So on the edges, there is a very low magnetic strength. Taking this advantage of the magnets, the fan is rotating so fast. Now there is a next one, a snake puppet. Observe the movement. Can you think a science behind this? There is a change in a motions, basically change in a linear motion to curvilinear motion. Also, observe the tongue of the snake. Tongue of a snake does not change their motion. Here is the next one. That is a flicker ball. For this, very simple material used. Ball, plastic cup and a stick. From this, can you relate any Newton's laws? Think on that. Now, here are a man made up of wire. And this wire man cutting the wood. How? The wire man connected to the crank. While moving the crank, there is a movement of up and down. So that's why it looks like a wire man cutting a wood. Now here is a two wire man. Observe the movement of the wire man. And here is a box man. For making of the box man, using such a trash box and some foam strips are used. This box man can walk also. Look at its movement. Isn't it fun to see such a beautiful toys made from trash which is having a huge hidden science in it? Let's take a look at this wire man. Observe the bolts that are hanging on its legs. If you balance this wire man on your finger, he will balance perfectly. Even if you try to make it fall, it will not fall. Why is this happening? Okay, let's take a look at another wire man. If you balance this guy, he will also balance perfectly. Now, if you bend one of his legs, look at how he's tilting. To make him straight, we will have to bend the other leg as well. The third wire man is holding a wire with some weights towards the end. This man is also perfectly balanced and will not fall even if we push him. Why is this happening? Observe this beautiful butterfly that is made with foam rubber and rubber tubes. Look at how it sits perfectly on a plant that is also made by Poddar sir. Observe the two weights placed in front of its wings.
center of mass, as we all know, is the point at which all the mass of the object is considered to be concentrated. Remember, all the mass is not actually concentrated on this point. It's just done so that the calculations are easier. But you can balance objects on this point.
Now let us try to play a game based on this concept of center of mass. Can we balance all of these nails on the head of this one nail? Let's try different methods. If I take one single nail and try to balance it on the top, it's very difficult to do, but somehow I can do it. Now, how do I balance the second one? Do I keep it on the top of the first one? No, they all fall down. There is an amazing way of doing this which involves center of mass. Finding the center of mass of the system that is made up of all of these nails. If we arrange the nails like this, one at the base and another one at the top like this, we will be able to lift all the nails and place them exactly where the center of mass of this system is. Which means that we are now able to balance all of these nails on the top of just one nail. Can we increase the number of nails? Of course we can. Technically, we should be able to balance infinite number of nails on the head of just one nail. Isn't it interesting? Even if we try to tilt this structure, it will not fall. Just like the toys that we saw before. Poddar sir has made a lot of dynamic toys along with some models that are shown here. Using very easily available material like wires, an old CD, skewers, old pieces of sunmica, refills of pens, old newspapers, beads. These things are beautifully made and we can decorate our desks with these very easily. All we need to do is be creative.
Isn't it interesting how so many toys can be made from material that is easily available all around us? Poddar sir makes these materials from trash that we generate in our everyday lives. So let's make a lot of such toys together and keep the curiosity alive.
Hope you like this segment of dynamic toys. Stay tuned for other sessions. Thank you.